What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Critical Overlord here. So some unfortunate news regarding the upcoming Child's Play TV series. Apparently the show was supposed to start filming later this fall in Toronto, Ontario, in the Canada area. That unfortunately is not going to happen thanks to our ongoing pandemic that has no end in sight, despite many people thinking that it's somehow miraculously going to just be declared over, or coronavirus, the pandemic might be declared over, but the coronavirus isn't going anywhere anytime soon. But production on that has been delayed till 2021. Sometime in 2021, I don't think they gave out a date. I'm looking at all the articles here. And recently, a producer, Nick Antosca, who I believe worked on Channel Zero with Sci-Fi, who's also working on the Sci-Fi adaptation or the Sci-Fi TV series and the USA Network TV series for Chucky that's upcoming, he had some thoughts to say about the upcoming project. He stated that Don wrote an awesome show, he's showrunning it, and he had a great writer's room. I'm cautious about talking details, but we're working on it every day. As a Chucky fan, I'll just say I'm over the moon that Brad Dourif is back as Chucky, as well as some other familiar characters, and that I think fans are going to love where Don is taking it, and new audiences are as well. It's scary, it's really funny, it's very smart, nobody knows Chucky better than he does, and he's pushing the boundaries yet again. I can't wait for everyone to see it next year. Now, this new Chucky series that we all know is coming out next year is going to air on the USA Network as well as Sci-Fi. Well, we believe it to come out in sometime next year. They're going to shoot it in 2021, and I believe the plan is to still release it sometime later next year, given the teaser that we recently got, which I believe highlighted 2021 for the release year. That could change given what happens with the filming that has now been shifted into 2021 when it was supposed to occur this fall. Right around the corner. We were so close, and this pandemic just ruining yet another thing that us in the horror community cannot wait to see. Because with this TV show, I feel like they're gonna do some. They have the chance to do great things. When I say great things, I'm talking about we have a chance to develop these characters more. We get to hopefully spend more time catching up with Andy Barkley, if he's ever gonna be featured in any episodes, depending on how many episodes that character will be featured in. We'll get to catch up with, I believe the main character is supposed to be someone of the LGBTQ community. I believe it's supposed to be a young male who is homosexual. I believe that's what I read somewhere. But hopefully we'll get to spend a lot more time, of course, with that character, to get to know that character and get to see his bond with Chucky. Because as far as I know, the actual plot synopsis, and this is from the best of my memory, it is after a vintage Chucky doll turns up in like a small suburban type town, I believe at a yard sale or some sort. And then after that, this town is just thrown into like just turmoil because a series of like typical murders will occur because we have a Chucky doll in the area. And I believe we're supposed to find out some type of secrets and all these other things that are tied to the doll that has shown up in this town. And it's pretty obvious that this is probably going to be Charles Lee Ray's hometown. And we know Brad Dourif will be back to voice the killer doll. We know that Jennifer Tilly is going to be back to play Tiffany. She made her return she was in Curse of Chucky, but she was also in Cult of Chucky. And she'll be returning once again for this TV series. We're expecting Fiona Dourif to be back to play her character, Nika. I expect her to be back just because of the simple fact that her character was Chucky literally got into her body at the end of Cult of Chucky. We know the TV series is supposed to be bringing in parts or continuing parts that we left off with from Cult of Chucky, and also catching us up on parts from Seed of Chucky. And by that, it sounds like we're possibly going to be getting to see Glenn and Glinda brought back. How that would translate on screen all these years later, I do not know. I know that just for many years after Seed of Chucky has been in the world, and after many people have been watching this franchise for numerous years, where we didn't have anything after Seed of Chucky, and we had to wait multiple years, almost a decade, till we got Curse of Chucky. A lot of people grew some type of fondness for that character, Glenn and Glinda. And that was like our first real showing of inclusion from this narrative or from this franchise. Other than the fact that I believe Don Mancini himself is a part of the LGBTQ community. So it's not really that shocking that he wants to dive into exploring a different take on Chucky with a member of that community involved in the narrative as the central character. Now again, it's pretty much blatantly obvious that this town that we're going to be set in is going to be the hometown of Charles Lee Ray, And I'm pretty much confident that the secrets we find out will have to do with how he ultimately led, or how he ultimately became the Lakeshore Strangler. How he not only, well, we know how he ended up in the doll, but like we'll probably find out other details that we can now associate with the other movies that contributed to him ultimately finding himself in this pint-sized killer doll body. And to the best of my knowledge, Nika, played by Fiona Dorff, I expect her to be back. Jennifer Tilly, of course, is already set to come on board. That's official. And then Alex Vincent, Andy Barkley, I haven't heard anything about him possibly being in the show. The only two people who have actually been confirmed so far are Brad Dorff, Chucky, obviously, and then Jennifer Tilly playing Tiffany. All we have is the bride and the husband. We just have those two so far. Nothing really concrete about anyone else. All we know now is that production is not going to start till 2021 sometime. Another character everyone is expecting to see brought back is Kyle. Kyle is a very memorable character for me. I grew up watching Child's Play 2 so many times. I literally remember renting it from Blockbuster more times than I probably should have. If it wasn't me renting Scream, I was renting Child's Play 2. I watched all of the Child's Play movies, all of these horror movies at a very young age, an age I probably should not have been watching them, but I'm very glad that I did. I probably would hate to be, I sometimes kind of feel bad for the people who are just now discovering some of these films, such as the ones me and I know many of you guys who are listening to me grew up watching at a very young age, and you probably shouldn't have been watching them either. It's just baffling to me when I have people who tell me they haven't seen a Chucky movie or they haven't seen a Freddy or they haven't seen Scream. It's just baffling to me. But I love Child's Play 2. I love the character of Kyle. I hope she comes back. She was in the end of Cult of Chucky. She had a cameo, and that was after many years of us wanting to see that character back. And Don Mancini finally did. He always, I will give him that. When it comes to characters being brought back, he'll deliver in that aspect. But Cult of Chucky, for me overall, as a entry into the franchise, I thought it was a step in the opposite direction. Like, we were leaning into Seed of Chucky territory. I thought that the seriousness of him being able to duplicate his soul into multiple bodies now, it came off more jokey than serious. So I'm going to be more appreciative if this TV series will go back to the roots of that original classic movie from 1988, where we have Chucky just being flat out scary. We might have a few scenes where we don't get to see this doll, because that's what I appreciate about Curse of Chucky. We know the doll is alive, but Curse of Chucky, you kind of felt like more it was building up to it. You could feel a build up from it. I want that back in this franchise. And I know you can't, I won't say you can't, but at some point you're going to have to try to like switch it up a bit. But that original film and Curse of Chucky, I feel like they do it just fine. They do it just fine. You know the doll's alive. And especially with Curse of Chucky, it had been so many years since we saw Chucky, but they did such a good job with building it up for us to finally see him again. And I don't think we got that with Cult of Chucky. Cult of Chucky was leaning more towards the Seed of Chucky territory. So I'm hoping with this new upcoming TV series that hopefully will still premiere in 2021 sometime, we'll get to see all of that stuff from the original movie with all that stalking and like building up the anticipation for us to finally see the doll that is alive, that we all know is alive, and get to see him do what he does best. And other than that, what Nick Antalska had to say about the project, I am just even more excited about it. If Don Mancini has really poured his heart and soul into this, I have no doubt that this TV series will ultimately be a hit with us as horror fans. It might not be that good to attract a large audience, because I hope and pray that we get many seasons of this, because I know what the ultimate end game will be is for this TV series to then bridge into two final movies. I believe Don Mancini has stated he wants to make at least two more movies, but this is kind of like the bridge gap. Anyone else notice how Don Mancini is doing what Victor Salva wanted to do in a way? But Victor Salva, unfortunately, we know can't do it. So I just wanted to throw that out there. He's kind of doing what Victor Salva wanted to do with Jeepers Creepers. I just thought that was a cool mention to make. But anyways, I'm really excited. Can't wait. Kind of disappointed about production being delayed. But let me know what you guys think about all this down in the comment section below. I'm going to leave a link to the Facebook group. You go ahead and join it if you want to. And of course, if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe. Turn on post notifications so you never miss a video. In the description, I have links on my social media accounts. I'm on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can message me there to let me know if there's any movies, news, or reviews you'd like me to cover in the future. And of course, with all that in mind, guys, I will see you in the next video.